deal, family? It's your man Antonio here representing Yoke Lifestyles. And in today's video, we're going to be going over three movements to further grow and detail your front delt, lateral head of the deltoid, and rear delt. So first, we're going to go on with the cable lateral pulls. And this is for side delt, lateral delt, however you want to describe it. You don't need heavy weight. You see a lot of guys, females too, I ain't gonna single nobody out. A lot of guys, a lot of females like to use really heavy weight. This is not a heavy weighted compound movement. You just wanna isolate the side delt. So we're gonna get into a demonstration and then we're gonna move on. In the same motion as well. You don't want to go too high, take the tension off the side, and you don't want to come down too low because you're taking the tension off the side. So you want to keep it immediate. Always go high reps, 15 to 20 reps per set. I'm not about to do 15 to 20 reps. Quite frankly, they hurt right now, and I'm just describing it. Again, you don't need heavy weight for the movement. You just want to keep tension on the side delt, pump the blood in there, isolate it, and grow. Second movement is called a dumbbell incline rear fly. You see it perform wrong a lot because you really gotta go for feel. So what you wanna do, you're gonna be on the bench at an incline. And when you're on the bench at an incline, when you go into the motion, you want to have it to where it's like your pinky just pointed up. So, like I said, it's a little hard to grasp in the beginning, but it's a movement you do for feel. I'm gonna do a few reps of it again. You don't need heavy weight. You just want to isolate and pump blood to the rear delt. So, I got me some 12.5 dumbbells right here. I'm gonna do a few reps and hope you guys understand it's a high rep movement. You want to get at least 12 to 15 reps per set. And again, you want to keep it all in the same movement, the same motion. 12 to 15 reps per set at a slight incline. And you want the imagination to be like you pouring a cup of tea or something like that. So your pinkies is always pointed up. pointed up. That way, you feel most tension on the rear delt. Alright, the final movement is an easy curl bar, front raise. We're doing it with the incline bench again, the same way we did the rear delt dumbbell flies. I know you're probably wondering like why he's not doing any pressing movements. Why pressing movements? Not in his top three movements that he do for dump day. And the reason why I don't do it is because you do a lot of pressing on your chest days. So, you know, doing incline, flat, decline pressing, you always going to incorporate some front delts. So that's why I do press on my shoulder days, but I don't make it a predominant movement. I don't really emphasize pressing movements on my shoulder days. So again, we're doing a front delt raise. Using this easy curl bar, going how you an incline bench, set it up. You don't want to come too high, you're taking the tension off the front delt. You don't want to come too low, you're taking the tension off the front delt. You want to keep it at a medium. Medium. Trick to this movement, setting up like you're about to press. You want to retract your scapula and drive your rear delts and your traps down into the bench. It's going to further support you in the movement. I'm going to do another demonstration. Hope you guys enjoyed this. Hope these tips were very helpful. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. It's highly appreciated. And I'll see y'all in the next video.